Hey guys, so this is Serenity's 2 week update. She's 2 weeks and 1 day as of today. A little update on Serenity is last Thursday we went to a doctor's appointment and they checked her weight. She started at 6 pounds and 9 ounces when I gave birth to her in the hospital, and now she is 6 pounds and 12 ounces, I believe. Because I am breastfeeding, the doctor explained to me that she breastfed babies tend to gain the weight back really fast. So she has definitely done that. She's gained her weight and then some, which I'm really happy about. Also, her umbilical cord fell off. It fell off, I believe, on Friday. Call me weird, but I keep it. My mom has all three of her kids' ones. She has mine, my brother. Call me weird, but I like those sentimental things. So I was like, I'm gonna keep it. Also, while I was at the doctor's office, she prescribed to me a vitamin drop. Supplement for her. It's vitamin D. She explained to me that babies tend to not have enough vitamin D in them, and even though I'm breastfeeding her, even though I'm taking my prenatal vitamins still, I still don't have enough vitamin D for her. So she is taking little vitamin D drops. The amount of poops she does a day is about a million. She does so many poops a day and so many pee-pees. I have to change her a lot. But that's a great sign that she's getting fed well and she is hydrated. So I'm perfectly happy with that. I do breastfeed her. I breastfeed her every 2 to 3 hours and she is on schedule with that. Like, she is on point. She will wake her own self up every 2 to 3 hours. It doesn't matter if she looks like she's knocked out at a certain time after 2 hours have passed, she will wake up and she'll be like, "All right, mom, time to feed me." And at first with breastfeeding, my breasts were very engorged. They were really, really bad. I mean, even though she was feeding every 2 to 3 hours, in the beginning it was even every hour. And it was really hard because my breasts were getting very sore and it really hurt. Breastfeeding is not supposed to hurt, and it really, really hurt. So I knew something was wrong there. It turned out that I wasn't latching her on properly. I only let her latch on to the nipple, and that is incorrect. The milk does not come out from the nipple, it comes out from the breast. So you want to like latch the baby onto the entire breast. Not the entire breast, but just the areola part that is surrounding the nipple. And I wasn't doing that, so that's why it hurt really bad. I mean, it hurt like there was no tomorrow. And breastfeeding is not supposed to hurt. And now I have it down pat. I mean, it doesn't hurt at all. I can literally sit down, breastfeed her, and do 10 other things while I'm at it. I really want to get the Mobi wrap. And I cannot get it yet until she weighs 8 pounds. So I'm really looking forward to her weighing 8 pounds because she is very spoiled already. I mean, I don't know what happened. Like, naturally, I just like her close to me and I love holding her and I love this position here. I really, really do, because it's like I'm connecting with her even more. And so I tend to pick her up a lot and she has noticed that, I guess. She's a very smart baby already because as soon as I put her down in her swing, at my mom's house, we have a little swing. We also have a bassinet that vibrates, and we have her crib. I can put her in the swing. I turn it on, and it swings for her, and she kind of likes it. Like, if I put her in now, she'll be okay because she's very knocked out. But if I put her in any other time, she screams bloody murder. Like, she has such a high-pitched screech that I just immediately pick her up. I don't really like her crying very much. As soon as she starts to cry, I go and I pick her up and I snuggle her or I cuddle her, or depending on what she wants, I feed her or I change her diaper. You know, and if I've done all of those things and she's still screeching to the top of her lungs, I'll just do this position and she'll calm right down. I think my heartbeat soothes her, and I don't really mind this position at all. If I had the Mobi wrap, this is exactly what she would be in all the time. Okay, someone wanted to move into a different position. Anyways, guys, that concludes Miss Serenity's little 2 week update. I'm gonna try to do weekly updates, but I'm not promising anything because she does keep me very, very busy. So hopefully my next video will be next Monday or sometime during this week. I'll probably do a video. I want to squeeze in a day in the life with a little newborn because mostly I am alone during the day and I'd like to show you guys what exactly I do with her every single day. My mom usually comes home at about 5 o'clock, and my boyfriend, depending on his schedule, he's either here with me or he's working, so someone's awake. Yeah, but she's probably gonna start fussing right now and probably want to be fed again. So I'm gonna cut this video short here. It's probably not short, it's probably rather long. I'm gonna cut it here, and yeah, if you guys have any suggestions on videos that you guys want me to do. Alright, so if you have any video suggestions for me, definitely just leave them in the comment section below and I'll try and do them. But again, I'm not promising anything because she does keep me really busy. Oh, and another thing, on Wednesday she'll have her first bath because, like I said, her umbilical cord fell off, so it fell off on Friday, and we're gonna give it five days to, like, at least heal up. The doctor said three, but it's still looking a little pussy and it's kind of still moist, so I don't want to take her a bath until at least Tuesday. So I will probably be doing a video on her first bath and how she reacts to the water and stuff like that. So again, I'm not promising, but I'm definitely gonna try. All right guys, bye.